To give Lincoln another shot here. My first play, I feel like I made a serious error with the Union using my boat cards to try to help the blockade, and I think it's far more important to try to grab a port. It's a quicker way to get the two victory points necessary to make it through that first duck. So let's see what the Union has to begin with. And they actually start off with boat card, which can be used as a shipping card. Rather than doing a Manassas, I think what I want to do is generate an attack. So I'm going to discard one of these. Shit. I can only move one boat in. Oh boy. This is iffy. If I had two boat cards playing this, I could ship two units down there. Now, I could hold on until I get that. That might be my best move. In which case, do I want to launch an attack? I don't know. Right now, the Confederates are kind of weak. I could grab a quick point down in Nashville. That's probably my strongest place to launch an attack. Am I too aggressive? I don't know. So I'll put a strength point here. And I hold my boat. I will play this to move. And I'll play the big 3-point attack card, using my best general. And we'll see what the rebels have in terms of a general. Wow, they got lots of good cards. They got a cavalry, which can soften up the enemy. But I think my best move is to play this 4-point defense. Even though this is a 5, I'm not sure. But I'm gonna play the 4-point defense. That gives me a 5. No defensive benefit here to 3, 4, 5, 6. The Confederates lose, but the Union loses half their force as well. They're not affected by the limit. Maybe I shouldn't have fought, because the Union has just taken Nashville. That's worth a victory point, and that right away gets me further along than I had been. And we get 3 quick cards back. Come back over to the rebels. And we're very unhappy about this, because it means our defensive structure is compromised now. I could put a fort in Chattanooga. This is going much, much worse. And this is my only 1-point card. Okay, so this is gone, and I'm gonna discard this 3-pointer. I'm gonna play the 1-pointer to generate a unit to defend Chattanooga. And now naval is not affected. And we get a handful of cards. That first attack worked. What do we want to do now? It's a good question. I believe we're allowed to put troops anywhere we control that's in line, which means we could reinforce Nashville, which, being worth a victory point, is perhaps the best of the choices. Let's see. Deploy a unit. In a controlled location that you have. Well, that's appealing. This is probably my most valuable location right now. Do I want to get rid of a card and get a 2-point army somewhere? Yeah, I don't know. Got this higher ground that's going to give me a defensive benefit. I got a couple of 2-point defenses without expending my naval card. So yeah, what if I play this? This is a more valuable card than this to me. So I am going to discard that and get myself another 2-point unit. Where do I want to put it? That's a good question. I'll put it up here. And that almost assures if I make an attack, though, it's a problem. Why don't I put that instead down here? And this card goes away because it's a card that's greater, that's not a 1-point attack combat card. And I'm going to play my 1-point combat card up here in Washington, opening up that range. And I'm holding for that second boat. I feel like that's a key issue that I had to remember. Now, one thing with the Rebels is, first of all, I had a better card and could have defended harder. Secondly, I could have withdrawn back and built up a bigger force. And I chose to do neither and lost a victory point because of that. What do we got? Well, oh, I sure don't want to play this. The blockade's not moved anywhere. And it's a good card. High ground is a good defensive card. Rail movement, I don't have a lot of free units to shift around. This is a good combat card. It's a possible movement card. Gosh. So, if I was going to launch an attack, I would want to build more troops. I don't have a 1-point card, so I don't have anything I can get rid of cheap. I think this card is pretty crappy, and I can afford to get rid of it to create a 2-point unit. I have to discard a card. This is too good. This is too good. Between these two, this one is less useful. Where am I going to put that extra 2-point unit? Put it up here. Defend the West a little harder. Because I got a 1-pointer in the West. What about my second action? Is there anything I want to do with that? I don't particularly want to get rid of any cards. And I don't particularly want to launch an attack, do I? I'd get a bunch of cards if I launched an attack. I could push up here, maybe. But there's nothing of value up there. There really isn't. And that's something that I want to hold off on, is making valueless moves. I mean, it gets me space, you know, if I make that attack. Do I want to blow a good combat card on that? I'd be at +1 to begin with. I lose some defensive terrain though. I'm gonna just take my draw. And that puts it back with the Union. Union, I've got a draft card. I'm gonna play it. It's a free action, gets me 3 cards, another shot at getting naval. But I don't find it. Oh, that's troubling. See, if I could almost assure that I could win the battle, but this is my only good commander. The next one down is a 2. We'd be looking at a 5 to a 2. Make it a 3. There's almost no chance I would succeed. So, we do not want to launch an attack. And instead, what are we going to do with this shit? Well, we don't want to launch a naval attack. We would like to gain another victory point. Possibility here. I could drop a big card, but that's my... Oh no, I got a 2-pointer here. And I got a movement card. That would get me my second victory point. I don't know that I actually really need that. I like the idea actually of holding off. So I'm gonna play, that doesn't get me any new cards. That's the problem. If I just hold off, I don't get a draw. What I was gonna do is just drop a one into here and here and create a defensive network, but that isn't enough for the Union. So this is my easiest to attack location. It will not, in the valley, it will not give me a card. Or it will not give me a victory point. All right, I think I need to get rid of this and drop two cards. It's like all my combat, you know. Put a three in here. Get rid of this. And we need to do something else, which will be launch an attack at plus one. Right? I got another choo-choo. Hold on. I could launch an attack at plus two instead. We'll do that. Or do we want to go for Manassas, which puts us near Fredericksburg, which is worth a second point? Fredericksburg's hard to take, though, from that direction, whereas it's easy in these two. So we'll go here. And do we want to defend? Well, we could do a hell of a defense. We got an even better one. We got an even better one. Jeez. Okay. He's got an attack card. Probably no more than plus four. That would be 7, 8, 9. I would need to do this and this to tie him. If he's got a really good card. We know he doesn't. Okay, so that's 7, 8, 9 in defense. 2, 5, 6, 7. That's a loss. Uh-oh. We won a battle, and now we've lost a battle. Have real trouble remembering that aspect of the game. That's the Union turn. The Confederates have very, very few cards left. Three more cards for the Union, which could make them very powerful. And do we want to be on the offensive for any reason? Still no reason to play this, and we actually really don't want to. This is my best defensive card. Is it okay for me to just delay? Or do I want to push forward somewhere? Pushing forward here does me some good. I've got to move. I could not build a unit. And without that, I can't do it. I could just build a unit. Which might not be a bad idea. Get rid of this. I'll discard this. I get a two-pointer. And this is the more important location. That gets me four more cards. Back to the Union. We got two boats. Okay, so that's sweet. That means we can launch an attack. Do we have a general? we got a 3-point general. We don't really need to recover, or a 2-point general. We don't really need to recover forces. But building forces can be useful. So I'll play a 2-point card here. Is this my move that I need? I don't need a move. To discard this. And I will put a 2-point unit here. That gets rid of this. That's one action. Second action is I play both my naval movements and drop a card to slide these where? Three. We'll go down all the way to Savannah. Alright. Well, what's our defensive on this? For our good, we've got a lot of strength. So if he's got like a 4-point card, he could be... I could just retreat. That would be the safe move, right? But I've got a 3, so he's at plus 1. If he's got a 4-point, he's at 5. Net. I could match that just with this combat card. Or I could use my defensive higher ground and keep some of my better cards. What did I say? 5, right? So I'm assuming he doesn't have anything better than a 4. Maybe a mistaken assumption. But if he has a 4, he's coming in with 8. I'm at 3. I need to come in with 5. So I defend with this and drop a higher ground. The Union is weak. Only a 6 to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't even take a loss. This is lost, but now we have a retreat problem. What's up with the retreat problem? I think I need a naval card to retreat. If the attacker loses, he retreats to the location. If he attacked from within the same location, he retreats. No, I believe he gets to go back. Let me see, because there was something about... Maybe it's withdrawal. Union player may withdraw or retreat from a location reached by naval movement by playing a card with a naval movement symbol. Units are moved back to Washington. If he cannot play the requisite card, he cannot withdraw or retreat. This is weird because it's under withdrawal, but I think it applies. And that was a pretty horrible situation for the Union. Could I have waited for a better card? Maybe, but, you know, I feel like I expended so much on the naval action, and I'm again being thrown into a, wow, I'm kind of at risk here. That brings me over to the Rebels. Well, we have some pretty decent combat cards, but I think my best move may be to use this crappy card to build a big army. I'm not going to be able to hit this if he puts a defense up. Oh, geez. He can't. I think I screwed up. What did we have? We have this. Yeah, I screwed up. It's game over again, because I can just go in there. There's no defense there, because I fucked up. I could have put this, which I built, into here. In which case, I could have brought that with me. Let's make this a little bit less of an advantage for the Union. I could have brought the 2 with me instead of the 3, had a slightly higher strength, and of course the Confederates might have played a bigger card then, but Okay, we'll just leave that as it is. Because I need to leave a garrison in Washington, otherwise it can just be taken. That plus 10 isn't worth anything if there's not something to defend it. Well, my chances of taking Washington are zero. Which means I still think I want to do the same thing, just discarding this, grabbing the three-point army, and I'll put that down here, getting myself a bunch of other cards. And that's one of them. Oh, look, I just made myself lose the game through stupid maneuver. You know, it's pretty easy to do. The smaller the game, the easier it is to completely fuck it up. All right. On the Union side, I have a paper money card. That's a nice card. Why is it so nice? Because I can burn a couple of iffy cards. How important is defense to me? I don't know. But I could certainly burn these two, which are kind of crappy cards overall, and build myself a pair of deuces. And then still, I could launch an attack, but I got no leader, so I can't do it. So let's play this to get ourselves a pair of deuces. And let's discard this to get a one. Yeah, we're burning through our hand. Put the one here. I don't feel like I can take a naval action very easily. So I'll put the deuces there. The one goes back. Not allowed to get rid of that crappy card. I'm not sure I want to, you know. Deck size is actually important to the Union because that's their timer. And the Confederates have a full hand this time. Reinforcements, very, very useful. I can shift things between these two. They're not going to help here. The round that is in the wrong direction. But yeah, I don't want to just play that. Higher ground, always useful. Possibly a nice combat card. I don't really have enough left that I can do an attack with, right? I could launch this. I could use this to launch this. Well, I could build this and it would destroy a unit. That's fine. But otherwise, if I wanted to just do an attack, I could actually use this as my movement card, use this as my general, and I'd have a fair chance of taking something. Maybe this. But I don't have any strength there. So, what I want to do, I think, build myself a couple of 1-point infantry and put them. I'm not really sure I want a 1-pointer. Like, I'd really like to get a better unit here, but whatever. And that draws over here. What's the Union got? Got paper money again. I got a ship card. I can start building stuff up. Play paper money again. We don't really have an attack that we can make easily with that ship card. We have a good general in a couple of places though. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a 2-point unit and a 3-point unit with this. Could have actually built some blockade, but again, I kind of made the choice the other way. And then that'll give me enough points that I could move and attack. Is the rail movement more valuable to me than the higher ground? No. And the higher ground is nice because I'm not having to discard a lot of cards. So where do I want to launch my attack? Chattanooga looks good because of that big defensive position there. So let us put all of our forces in the west. Start threatening Atlanta. And now I only have one movement card, which I'll do. I gotta keep a defense here. And I will play my leader there. I'll move these down. What kind of defense do the Confederates have? Another option would have been to launch the attack across here, where there's only a plus one. So the reason the fort's interesting is he can't just fall back from that. Let's see. How about I build here instead and launch this attack in the west? I think that makes more sense. I'm going to lose two units, though, pretty much no matter what. Whereas if I put the two units over here, I would have five. I would still only lose two units. Yeah. Let's do this. And we'll launch the attack into here. Okay. Confederates have to make a decision. I'm facing 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 with 6. Would it make more sense to attack here? 4, 5. Yeah, no. I have a better superiority there. Okay. Well, we have lots of yummies. So, if we're facing 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, let's make sure there's not a defense there. There is not. 11 to my 6. That's a 5-point difference. Well, I have a 5-point leader. What were we talking? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 to 6. It's a 5-point difference, but let's say he's putting a 3 or a 4 in there. Now it's a 9-point difference. A 9-point difference is tough. I can get 7 off of this if I use the high ground and the 5 leader. I could get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 by using the reinforcements option instead. Odd, I defend. I choose not to defend and fall back, giving him this position. Good, bad, I don't know. Next time he attacks, he can hit me, but he throws away his card. I get to see it. I don't get to look through his discards, but I do get to see, you know, what he played when he discards it. And in this case, it's a 4. At least as far as I can tell. And the Union draws a whole pile of cards. That deck's beginning to get low again, and I've only got one victory point. This, even if I capture it, isn't worth a point, but it's near things that are worth points. I need a little bit of a break for the Rebels. Things that my decision, based on a die roll of all things, of course, wasn't too clever about was I didn't consider what my next turn is going to be. I'm holding a shitload of nice defensive cards. This would have been the time to use them. Now, it's not so easy. The reinforcements can't be used. That's okay. They're not that great. That's a good leader. I got the high ground. That's my defensive stuff. What else do I want to do? Is there someplace I could put a 2 that I really like? Yeah. I'm not counting on this being too great. So I'm going to put a 2-point card counter here. That strengthens the defenses there. They're pretty strong already, but that's one card. Do I want to do something with this? Just discard it? Not particularly, because I don't really want to run through my deck. Let me go back over to the Union. And I think it's time for a bit of a longer break. One mentioned, geez, this doesn't, not quite the words. Actually, what they mentioned was, you can't play chess solitaire because you know what the opponent's thinking. I don't know what the opponent's thinking in this game. You would look at this and say, this is not solitaire playable. I was really worried that it would be that way. That it would feel like, say, a game of Magic or something along those lines. But there's not a lot of interaction in terms of, like, you don't have to check the opponent's cards a lot. If you can segment your brain and forget what's in the hands, it's actually not that hard. Now, you're losing something. There's no question. You know, look, if you're playing this face-to-face, there's the idea of, like, an attack as a feint so that you can make another attack, and that probably benefits the Union the most, especially late in the game when they have a much bigger hand than the Confederates do. But, you know, honestly, I'm finding this surprisingly easy to solo and fun. Fun in a way that most CDGs are not fun to solo. I found the same thing with the couple of the Finnish design games that I had. That they were, I don't know why. Not a lot of interaction cards, interrupt type things. Not a lot of heavy thinking behind it. You just were acting. And you could say maybe that's a sign that it's a shallow game or something. I don't feel like this is. Anyway. And not, you know, maybe it is the way I'm playing it, but I don't feel like it has to be, right? Go, I have very little problem solitaire playing Go. Go is not a shallow game. But the way I solo it, it is. All right, let's figure out what the Union wants to do. They're running deep into their deck and only have one victory point. I need to get another victory point. This attack did not really succeed. I have a good general. I have move cards. What else could I do? Like, my feeling is that standard, let's just grind forward, is the answer. How much do I overwhelm him? 4, 5, 6. I have an extra 5 strength points here. This is where I think the Confederates screwed up, was in making the attack that they did. Or in making the choice not to defend. So let's make them pay. Well, I can't just reinforce this. This is one of the issues there. Whereas there's a victory point just kicking right here that maybe I could take. Jeez. It's so fucking hard for me to think. So I want to keep this for the attack. I want to keep this for the move and attack. I would kind of like a 1 point card to defend, to launch the attack there, wouldn't I? Let's do it that way. I put a 1-pointer in. I play my move card, I play my face down card, and I launch an attack here. All right, so we're behind by only 1, which means it may be worth defending. He has maybe 3 or 4. I don't know if he has any 4-point leaders. Again, knowledge of the deck is probably pretty important in this. And I don't like having to have that kind of knowledge, but I guess it's not really different than knowing the quality of the leaders in die roll situations. Reinforcements is not going to help directly. It would help over there, but not maybe not all that much. If I just play this as a defense, I'm in decent shape. Or maybe I'm better off playing the higher ground and dropping this as my defense card. Okay, so I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 to 5, 6, 7, 8. Another success for the Confederacy. The Union has to lose 2 units, ouch, and is pushed back. I feel like the Union has a particularly hard job. That brings us over to the Confederates, and I gotta think some more. Great hand for what I need to do, but I feel like I need reinforcements here or here. Jeez. And maybe in the ports, although those seem hard to hit. And what I'm sitting on is a one card that I don't really want to get rid of. It's sort of my best defensive card. A card that'll discard both and give me a lot of strength. And I don't have extra strength points kicking around. That's the thing. If I had extra strength points, I could shift units with a movement action. But there never seem to be extra strength points because the Union is constantly grinding at me. So I think what I gotta do is I play... Oh, there are no more twos. Well, I guess I'm not allowed to do that. Jesus. I got no solution, man. I mean, I can hold a good defensive hand and probably hold them off, but I don't think that's the answer. The answer, my friends. I'll put a 3 here. I'm not thrilled with this at all. Because now I no longer have that strong defensive position. Well, I forgot to draw my Union cards. And if I walk away in that kind of situation, I may end up badly damaging a position. So what do I got sitting here? I got no leaders. Like, none of any value. Which is problematic. And I gotta get me some points. And I don't have an easy route for my points. I got a lot of pluses here. Do I want to launch an attack there? 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 to 6. That's +5 already. I can't build another unit. Not right away. I don't need a move card for this. I'll just drop that and launch an attack. Okay. If I withdraw here, I have to leave the space. So I would very much like to win this battle. Since there are no twos available, this is a good card to play. And I'll play the higher ground, and I'll hope for the best. Okay. And there's obviously no defensive between the two. So 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 13 to 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The Confederates win another battle. This one, hold on. The number of points for winning a battle is not always one. Okay, and this is like a little piece of the rules somewhere. Here it is. That's not bad. Oh, I didn't catch that extra piece. the number of counters lost by the losing player. So this is the situation we're in already, because I took two losses for the Union. But now the Union has to lose half his units. 3, 4, 5. That's going to be 3 units. Uh-oh. Confederates have to lose half their units. That's only 1, because they're rounded down. And that was terrible. Okay. We got another card to play. Europe's almost in the war. I'm really having a hard time with the Union. I think I gotta build me some stuff. And I will do... I'll build the 3-point army. Where? Wish I had a 1. That would be easier. I'll build a 3-point army down here to get me an even up. I gotta discard 2 cards. Which 2? These guys give me some combat ability at least. Discard these 2. Get rid of that. And that gets us 4. And now we're back to the Confederates. Hey, that can make this a much, much closer game. Like, it's almost at victory if I play that. Of course, I have to get rid of a card, and it'll get rid of my bonus bonds card, which are pretty damn useful for recuperating forces. The other problem is, I don't really want to get rid of either of these cards. This is a 3-point, well, they don't leave my deck. Okay. Yeah, I think we gotta do it. So we're gonna push this down, get this out of the game. That hurts. But we've got it so the Union kinda can't afford to lose another battle. We get to discard a card, and we'll discard this for a 1 strength point. We can't put it there, we don't control that, but we can put it here. And that gets me a new hand. The Union has the capacity to do diplomacy too. And given the situation, unless I can guarantee me a win in a battle, that seems, it strikes me pretty damn necessary. To launch an attack, well, to do this. This is definitely a time when I want more cards, even if it drains my deck. Okay, now I got 2 of those guys. That's interesting. One of them's a good leader. I can probably win a battle, gain some ground with that. If I drop, I mean, I don't think trying to fight this chart using political options is a way for the Union to win the war. Therefore, here I'm at 5 facing 6-7. That's not great. Here I'm at 6 facing 5. That's a little better. But I can do this differently from how I normally do it. If I discard 2 cards and get a 3-point dude, let's make sure we have what we need. We need this guy as our leader. We need a move card. Doesn't really matter what. Keep that as my move card. Because I'm going to be moving the unit in from there, reinforcing and launching the attack. And that that means I get to discard two cards. I like this one. Not really. Rail movement could be important to me in the near future. Jeez. Here's what I hate, though, is that I'm not getting a one-pointer. I wish I had the money card or whatever, but because I'm going to take real losses on this battle. You know, another option is I could just dump these two, but... So this could end up losing me the game. But, again, I don't think playing on this track is a good idea in general. Like, I would be giving up a decent card forever, just trying to prolong the eventual and not building up my position and not gaining any ground. But if I can bust through here, I open up a big hole in the Confederate position. Unfortunately, I just don't know if I have enough to do it. Okay, but that's the choice we're going to make. So I get to get rid of two. I'll get rid of these two. Put this here. Move this down. That's our attack. If the Confederates can win this, they win the game. So they probably want to defend. See what they're sitting with. Ooh, blockade runner. I like the other one that can get me a pile of cards. I got good leaders all over the place. Forts are awesome. I mean, not really, but they're cheaper 3-point units. I got lots of 4-point leaders. That's pretty cool. I got this, which will win me the game if I withdraw. I withdraw from combat. I would rather win the game. So, the Union used their two actions. The game is over. Because... Wait. Is the Europe... Hold on. Maybe I don't do that. Let's get this back. When is the Europe victory condition checked? Jesus. And these being Wallace rules, they're... It's an immediate victory. Yeah. Game is over, man. This is here. Union gets three cards. They're in trouble anyway, because this did not give them a victory point. Oh, I actually probably need to do this. Defend Richmond instead. Does this connect to Richmond? No, this is just goes back to Fredericksburg. I don't know. Anyway, game is over because I can play this, drop this down here. It's an immediate victory. Bang. I'm having a hard time winning with the Union. I don't know if that's me and playing solo, or, you know, the first time it was my old bugaboo, right? I failed to use the naval rules appropriately. Well, this time I tried and it didn't help. It stymied me. I don't know if it's, or it might be me playing solo and being able to somehow anticipate the defensive factors. It may be me just not realizing how big a force you have to push in with the Union to be able to get any ground at all, which feels a little wrong. But, you know, they only have to get two victory points in the course of the first deck. And then once they make it through that, they can make additional ground. Not getting those two victory points? I don't know how reasonable, realistic, whatever it is to say if the union hadn't done anything at all, they would just lose. But, you know, honestly, for the first part of the war, yes, they did capture, maybe not New Orleans, but they did capture some of the port areas and take them out of play. Again, I don't know about Savannah. They took this, and they made some ground in Kentucky. But, yeah. It feels to me like the game is a really tough call to make it through that first deck. And maybe I'm just stupid. I certainly was playing very naively the first time. I'm trying to be more clever this time, and boom, you know, the defensive capabilities that the Confederates have may just be overwhelming. In the first game, I had the Confederates fighting back, making attacks, etc. I don't think that's such a good idea in this second game. Now, obviously, if you can capture a blue area, that gets you additional spaces on here. So it's possible you might want to do a counterattack in some weird circumstances just to get that extra Europe value. But that's the only reason you'd be doing it, I think. For the most part, that idea of the solid South, just build up as much defense as you can and let the Union, you know, ram against your good cards as often as you can. And, you know, holding your hand isn't a bad thing, because your deck is going to get worse as the game goes on. The Union deck is going to get better. Obviously, I'm not in a position to say anything about, you know, the balance of the game after two solo plays, but I do feel kind of befuddled as to what the fuck the Union can possibly do. We'll send this up.